On your mark. Get set. Go!
These three players have the chance to win lots of cash and prizes, over $1 million, but they have to avoid the dreaded bankrupt as we go back to the 80s this season on SGNZ's number one show, Mega Fortune. And now, here's your swaggy host, Gary Newkirk.
Greetings, one and all. Welcome to the next exciting episode of Mega Fortune. This is season number 5, episode number 40. We're getting down to the nitty-gritty of things, but this is an episode where I'm actually looking forward to do, because this is where shit's gonna get real as it is. But let me introduce pretty much the stipulation. Anyways, in position number 1, Mr. Connor Maros, who has over 118,150, am I correct?
118,510. He needs $1,490 to qualify.
So Connor, if you win this game, you'll be in the TOC. So your thoughts for this particular game? You're pretty much at a big stake right now.
Yeah, this is getting a really intense game. So may the best person win.
All right. And in position number 2, Mr. Ron Dane Hall, who's the intern champion, is already in the TOC, but might continue his run, you may never know, with over $121,070. So your thoughts between that?
Well, like Connor said, may the best man win, and I'm Mom.
Okay. And in position number 3, we have a man who might stop the champions and might become the new one, you may never know. We have Mr. KMH. Your thoughts between against these guys and how you think they're doing in this episode?
First of all, the end of the show, I just want someone to suck my dick. but really, let's just see what happens.
Okay, well, anyways, gentlemen, please get your dial pads out, please, and thank you, because it's time for our first question, toss up as it is.
Can I answer now?
No.
May the best man win. I'm sorry, Gary, you're a girl. Continue.
Aww.
All right, of course he is a girl with that tiny pecker.
You'll be
fine. Okay, let's be real here. It's not a tiny pecker. It's one of two things. He's got really big nuts or he's got a big clit. All right, moving on.
All right.
No insults. No insults.
Remember, no insults. Right. All right, but anyways, here's your first question for $1,000. Listen carefully. How many pedals does a grand piano have? Kyle.
3.
That is correct. You got 1,000.
Yeah, shit. He probably knew that with the music.
Oh, yeah.
Again?
All right. For this question.
How much?
$1,000.
That was another 1,000.
No, that last one was 1,000. This is 2 grand.
They're garrison!
What?
Romy, get the bat.
It's drunk! What?
Okay.
Oh, there it is!
Right. You know the rules by now, Gary.
Here's the
You've never seen the right two?
You're gonna be like Barry Bonds.
Alright, for $2,000, here's the question. What kind of bird builds a nest no bigger than a thimble? I believe that's how it's pronounced. That was Ron Dane.
A hummingbird?
Should we take that? He said a hummingbird. Should we take that?
Yes.
Okay. Because more specifically, it's known as the bee hummingbird. But since you were right,
that's correct.
Regardless, so you're gonna get the points there, and Rondine, you'll be starting off our game. So, Corey, please show us and explain to us your little scoreboard you got.
I didn't invent it though, but I got it donated to a friend. I will make sure it's put in the credits later on. But for right now, let me kick on screen share.
Little, just like your pecker, Gary.
Alright, here we go, folks.
I'm not surprised.
Mind you, this will help make things a hell of a lot easier for y'all. Can you see this?
Here we go. Oh, wow, the screen.
Oh, anime!
Alright,
wow.
For the band.
A puzzle board!
I'm gonna turn off my camera. So anyways, folks, this is Corey's little new technique. Oh, sorry about that. We got Corey's little new technique for you all. And, for this particular, we're going to be using the computer as the puzzle board for this. And we're still using the format, but we're just going to have the camera point at this for this episode for you all. But anyways, category for this is going to be historical photograph. And, Ron Dane, you'll be starting off. So you ready to spin the... What the...
Yeah, that's
Penelope! get off the wheel.
Bitch, I'll slit your
Penelope, bitch, you suck my dick.
Jeez, get, yeah, Penelope, just go sit over here.
Just like one of my holes, player.
But anyways, Ron Dane, you ready to spin the wheel?
Yeah, let's spin the damn wheel, please.
Hold on, let me do that. Let me do a better spin.
Holy shit, it's got score and letterboards and everything. Shit, I'm out of a job.
Fuck. Fuck, let me do a better spin. There we go, much better.
Does it factor in all the countless wedges that Gary decides to put on the damn wheel?
Alright, 450, Ron Dane. Alright, let me hear him.
It's true, Skynet's taking over. Alright, here we go.
Alright, 450. Now, folks, I need to hear him for each player. So, yep, anyways, go ahead, Ron Dane. Give me a letter, please.
Okay, T, please.
You're gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4 of those T's up there. So go ahead, Corey, reveal where they are, please, and thank you. So you got 4 T's up on the board as it is. You got $450. What would you like to do now?
What spot is he in? 1, 2, or 3?
2. He's the yellow one.
Yeah, he's the yellow.
1800.
Mm-hmm. So anyways, Ron Dane, what would you like to do now since you got the 4 T's up there?
I will spin the wheel, please.
All right, let's see if I can get a better spin out of this thing.
Spin the pack.
All right, 200.
Cheap motherfucker.
You shut up.
H.
All right, so those H's, you are going to get a number of those as one H adding on. Corey, am I correct?
Yep.
All right, so one H.
200.
One H so far, adding 200. So that makes it 650, or 2050, close enough as it is.
Barely. One H, so 2,000. Wait. 450, 900, 1,800, 2,000.
2,050, okay.
2,050, where did the 50?
You said 250, right, Gary?
I said 250 in the next... No, I said
200. I said 200.
I said 200.
Yeah, I said 200. All right, let me deduct 50 off. Hang on.
Okay.
You fucked up already!
There we go. Simple, right. Motherfucker.
Goddamn Windows 98.
Now, folks, let me hear Ron Dane for a sec. Okay, go ahead. What would you like to do? Would you like to buy, spin, solve?
Check yourself off.
That.
I'd like to buy an E, please.
All right, as for those, you're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4 E's. Who left?
Right.
Who left? Nobody.
Sounded like someone left.
It sounded like someone tried to call someone and Skype Auto kicked it out.
Okay.
Its initials are RT.
RTF.
Rotten Tomatoes. But anyways, go ahead.
He said he's going to buy another vowel.
Another vowel for 1500.
What vowel would you like?
I, please.
All right, you're going to happily get 1, 2 of those I's up there and ask for names. Let's keep it off the show, please, and thank you of any relevance to this for the particular episode. But anyways, you got the 2 eyes up there. What would you like to do now? Would you like to spin, solve?
I'll get you a sandwich.
Or get a sandwich?
Spin.
Okay.
Hey, Gary, speaking of names, me and Isabella.
Beauty. Well, Ron Dane, I hate to say it's been landing on a bankrupt on 10 grand. All right, Mr. Kyle, your turn.
I gotta go.
Got a lot of nice stuff on the way I love to give away. Okay, the Johnny Ryan soda that is local here in the area that I will have to give away. I'll explain that later on. 500, pick up the gift tag.
R.
All right, as for those R's, you're going to get yourself 1, 2, 3, 4 R's up in the board.
$2,000.
Oh, boy, that's a lot of money. So there you go so far. Got the Johnny Ryan soda.
Gusta.
Solve the puzzle, and it's all yours. So what would you like to do now?
I'd like to suck a clit.
Well, Gary's available.
I'll buy an A.
Okay, as for those A's, you're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 A's this time.
750.
My goodness gracious, great balls of fire, man. You're doing a good job so far. All right. What would you like to do now? Would you like to buy, spin, solve? Your choice.
I'm gonna spin.
Okay, let's go ahead and give the wheel a whirl, see what you can land on.
I'm gonna spin, you bitch!
Alright, you landed on the new invention I created of the Vowel Prophet. I will explain that what it is. So basically, $500, try to pick it up. The Vowel Prophet is that, it's only used for the speed up round. Basically, if you land on, say, for example, $1,200 of the spin, just like with consonants, 1,200 per whatever the consonant is. If you want to get a vowel, just let me know you want to use your Vowel Prophet token, and you will get money for that vowel.
And it could come in handy if the price amount it lands on is worth a significant amount.
Uh-huh, so $500, try and pick that up. So correct, call the correct letter that might be up there.
Kevin S!
And sorry to say, there is one.
smart ass. $22.50.
You got the Vowel Prophet on your podium as it is, so go ahead, Mr. Kyle. You're doing good.
I'd like to buy an asshole. And by asshole, I mean an O.
Alright, you're going to get one, two of those as it is, so there's two O's. What would you like to do now?
I'm going to spin.
Okay, let's go ahead and do that for you. See ya. Alright, you landed on, new gift tag of the Pork Side Candies. Again, it's a local thing in Buffalo, but trust me, it's like getting an orgasm. It's heaven when you have this.
crap.
What letter would you like to try and pick up that gift tag?
I like an M as in no.
Alright, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 N's.
Another about 2,500 with that gift tag, so 4,500.
Uh-huh. Alright, good. Good job so far. So you got the park set, you got a couple good prizes, mini prizes so far. Alright, what would you like to do now?
One more.
Alright, let's go ahead and spin it again, shall we? Alright, you are going to land on... Okay, chance of the free vowel token. Again, 500, pick that up.
Give me a C.
Alright, you're going to get two of those, adding one more, so that's three C's altogether.
Six.
How much
grand
was that value?
1,500, 500 for each. Mm-hmm. So 1,500, 4,500, 6 grand. He's on a good start.
Yes, you are, so... You can
and that was a free vowel.
Mm-hmm. The vowels are still remaining, so you can do that, or you can spin or solve the solution.
I'm gonna solve the dick.
Okay, what's the solution?
The main concourse at Grand Central Terminal.
And boom, boom, bada, boom, he's correct.
And he is correct. And he had a good round because he's got two wedges that are worth some prize amounts. Mr. Garrison.
Alright, here is the prize that he has won. So, folks, I'm sorry if you saw that document, but here is the prizes you have won. You won yourself some local Buffalo, New York treasures. Some Johnny Ryan soda. You're going to get a whole supply of Johnny Ryan soda worth $1,670. Also, you've won yourself...
$1,670? Okay.
Uh-huh, and you've won... And also, you're going to win yourself some Parkside candies, any sponge candy of any flavor you want. This will be worth at a Mega Fortune price of $1,860.
$1,860, adding to the $1,670. Ending at 6,000, and the 1K from his previous earnings, so 7,000. I know it's right there. I'm just gonna make sure, cause measure twice, cut once. Ooh,
yep.
That sucks if you were if you're getting a brisk.
All right, so
10,530, perfect.
All right, so go ahead, Corey. Set us up the next puzzle as it is.
Okay, here comes the controversial. As you can say, the Mega Powerball round. Here we go. Now, this is going to be a little different than before if you haven't played this in a while. Every time you land on a wedge that is active, the balls will be worth 5 grand. For example, one wedge is 5, two wedges is 10 grand, and so on and therefore. And the Powerball wedge is the multiplier. The multiplier will double the amount only for the person who has that wedge. Land on all 5 wedges with the Powerball and solve it is $180,000.
Do me a favor, bring in Joey Acacia, someone.
Alright, someone bring in Ethan as well.
Yeah, get Ethan.
Alright, bring him on here as well. Alright, now let me... Alright, so anyways, folks, you had to look at Penelope for a second, but anyways, folks, here's your next part. Shit. Well, we got too many people on here, sadly.
Oh, shit. Oh,
it just killed.
Yeah, we got too many people on here.
I can leave.
No.
I was last, so it's okay.
Lady of the evening stays.
Nope.
Thanks. And the lady in the corner goes, Gary, go make some money.
You shut up. So folks, for the time being, someone's going to have to step out for the time being that I will bring you back on the call. I promise you that. Because we got to reveal the board as it is. So, yes,
I'll
please.
Get up now.
I said, I promise I'll bring the person back. I promise.
There's actually, we need two people. Actually, there's, I still can't turn on my video. I'll just leave and, just bring me back in when it's done.
Okay.
Alright.
Well, there we go, folks. Solved, no problem. But anyways, go ahead, Corey. Reveal the puzzle for us.
Okay, right. Gary, can you send me the 5 wedges?
Alright, the 5 wedges.
Can everyone see my screen off first?
Yes.
And folks, okay. I'll let you all look at Penelope for the time being. That's what I'm going to do. So Penelope can entertain you folks while that's going on.
I'll show you what a real pimp looks like, player.
G-O-L-D-D-I-G-G-I-A-G-W-H-O-R-E.
That's far enough to name my ex-wife.
Oh my god.
Gold digging whore?
Alright, so anyways, there it is, folks, for you all. So go ahead, for this particular round, the category for this is news headlines, specifically it's classic news headline. For this
Kyle
particular
starts.
Round, Kyle, you'll be starting off a round, so you ready to give the wheel a whirl for this?
Yes!
Okay, so, here we go. Let's spin
Thank you for those, Gary, I got them.
Okay. Alright, you landed on a bankrupt, sadly.
Son of a bitch!
Damn, oh, there goes his dollar. Oh, man. God damn. Is the rubber ducky there?
Well, he's...
Romy, I think he put a pantogram on the wheel.
He said it. He's sitting on the record, so... Anyways, Connor, your turn, finally.
Sure, let's play. Let's spin the wheel.
All right, $200 to start you off, so go ahead and get the letter, please.
All right, let's looky here. Let's see. T, please.
All right, a T, so you're going to have to get 1, 2, 3, 4 T's up on that foot.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
$100.
Mm-hmm. A lot of T's.
Alright, so far so good as it is.
What was that value, Gary?
It was worth 200.
Thank you.
Most welcome.
So, here you go, 1200.
Let's go ahead and reveal those.
5 T's up there for you all. Alright, go. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6. My bad. I said 5 by mistake. Yeah, I suck at counting. I get it. Alright, so go ahead.
Okay. Suck at counting, dick.
Yes, I know. Go ahead, Connor.
All right, let's see. I will buy a vowel.
All right, what vowel would you like?
Please.
You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You
seven,
said what?
8. He called an E. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 E's up there.
Wow.
Good number of E's up there for you.
Thank
now,
you.
What would you like to do?
I'll spin again.
Alright, let's go ahead and do that for you. See where you land on. Alright, $300.
H.
An H, he says. So let me
at 300, he said?
$300, so you're gonna get one H. Adding another one, so that's 2 H's.
It's 2 H's, Mr. Garrison!
I can count! But anyway...
Two!
Yeah.
Two.
Anyways, you got the 2 H's up there. What would you like to do?
1550.
Hey, here we go. I'm going to buy another vowel.
What vowel would you like?
I.
Yes, there happens to be... Whoa, hello.
Ah!
Ice cream!
Sorry,
cream.
There you go.
Exactly.
Anyways,
yummy ice cream!
You got 2 I's up there, so there you go.
2 I's, very good. 1300.
Which one, left or right?
Anyways, go ahead, Connor, you're doing good.
Thank you. I will spin, please.
Alright, let's go ahead and spin this right now.
Oh, I stuffed my face like a motherfucker.
Alright, Connor, you landed on the Mega Fortune prize wheel.
500 to pick up.
Yes, sir.
F, please.
What letter? Say it again, please.
S, as in salad.
Well, you get to pick it up because there's two of those S's up there, so...
So 2300, a salad, someone's lost mine, Gary. Okay.
All right, what would you like to do now?
Okay, I will buy another vowel.
All right, what vowel would you like?
A, please.
There happens to be at least two of those up there, so let's go ahead and get the A's on there as it is.
A ding!
Ding doing, and a ding.
Doing very well. 2050 with a price gift tag.
Yes, sir. Right. So anyways, go ahead, Connor. Vowels are still remaining. You can spin the wheel, gain more money and prizes, or solve the puzzle if you know the solution.
And here's the thing. You don't know how many wedges I've been landed on, but that's what makes it interesting.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. I will spin, please.
All right, let's do that for you. All right, you are going to land on... Oh, fuck, it's a bankrupt.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I gotta take the mega prize wheel. But anyways, go ahead, run.
Mine spins.
So let's go ahead and spin it.
Big dick.
All right, Ron Dane, you landed on the shopping spree gift tag, so that's 500. Pick that up.
Excellent.
N, please.
An N, she says. So there happens to be at least...
Holy shit.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of those N's up there.
Great grand.
Goodness gracious, boy. So you got the shopping spree gift tag on the puzzle, on the wheel, solve the puzzle, and it's all yours.
I'll spin.
Okay, we can do that for you.
Big money. Big black space.
Ooh.
Big black dick.
Ooh. Free spin.
You know what I'm talking about, player.
Free spin.
Another 500. Okay.
What letter again?
L is Lisa.
And Sally to say there are two of them.
Oh, another grand, so 4,000. Doing very well.
You got the pendant of life or the free spin, so a grand for that. What would you like to do now?
One more time.
All right, one more time, he says, so let's go ahead and do it.
He wants that money.
I want the life of the pendant of life.
Oh, well, Sally's the only one.
He's made it this far, and I think he should have solved it, honestly.
Well, I hate to say this, but you landed on a bankrupt, but... But would you like to use your pendant of life or a free spin?
Yes, please.
All right, let's go ahead and do that.
Yeah. Well, like I said, he still can make a lot of money just from solving it, because, like I said, it's the powerful.
Uh-huh. So what would you like to do, Ron Dane?
Spin.
Come on, click! Money.
Oh, and it's the bankrupt again, so go.
Double whammy.
All right, Kyle, your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna spin.
Yes.
All right, 300.
I'll take a C.
And you're gonna happily get one C up there, so there you
go. I'm gonna get one cock.
All right. 800.
All right, what would you like to do?
Spin again.
All right, let's go ahead and spin it again like you asked. Okay.
Spin my salad.
All right, the salad is spinning, and you are going to land on the money amount of a bankrupt, so...
Oh, my God!
Oh, no.
Dude?
Nope. Anyways, Connor, back to you.
I will spin.
I'm sorry. But anyways, you are going to land on $300 yourself.
Oh, another 300, okay.
I'll take an W.
There are two of them.
600.
Okay, what would you like to do now, Connor? You got the W's up there, what would you like?
I'll spin again.
Okay. Oh, would you like a cookie later?
I want a clit to suck on.
Hey, Gary, a cookie.
Cookie. Oh, Connor! Car wedge, 500 pickup.
Beep.
Car.
There are two R's in the puzzle.
Yes.
1600 with the car wedge.
All right. So I'm going to solve.
All right. Now, folks, silence for a sec so I can hear them.
Okay. The Wall Street crash of 1929.
There you go, attaboy.
Yay. Ta-da.
And you're probably wondering, How many wedges?
How many wedges?
1, 2, 3. So you add another $15,000.
The car wedge too.
Yes, but we don't know how much the car is. And the other two wedges were the 700 and the 450 full. That's 10,000 since it landed on three. So the Powerball will be worth 190,000 for the next game. Mr. Garris, what do you win for the car?
Well, Connor.
So what else do I add? Just the car?
I'm going to tell you right now, Connor, you are going to be in the lead for this.
Oh, my God.
Let's just say this car wedge is worth $21,630. It's a 2015 Chevy Malibu.
Oh my goodness!
So 15 grand, and then you add the hello there.
15 grand. Let me put that in as well. Yeah,
the 15 from the Powerball since it landed on the three wedge, and you saw.
Holy Mary!
And then you get the 1600 from this particular round, adding to the car, which is 21,630, gives him an overall total of 38,230.
Play some catch up.
Yep, so go ahead, Corey, review
it. But there's a reason why there's a power round in the early, because we still got a long game to go.
A long game. So anyways, go ahead, Corey, show us the next puzzle that you got with your magic wand.
Oh my God, I cannot believe it.
By his magic wand, you mean his dick.
Somewhat.
Oh, shit.
Despite everyone else, Rodney has the 2 grand from the toss-up, and Kyle has 10,530. It's still anybody's game.
All right, thank you for that clarification, Romy.
Now, folks, let's just have a moment of silence, please.
We all know
how much I respect you guys so much as it is. I love the dear fans of the show. And I don't like that one guy who dislikes the episode every time. But you know what? I would love him to some extent. But as for this, I still love my fans. I love you guys as well. Romy sometimes, he's a dick as well. But we all know he's going to be in the Hall of Fame now as it is. But it's that magical round where, you know, we all step aboard the...
That's my favorite round, me and my hoes, bitches.
It's the Trump train, bitch.
Yep. But anyways, Connor, since you saw that last puzzle, you'll be starting off this category. For this one is a magazine title. So anyways, Connor, let us know what you would like to know.
All right, here we go. Spin the wheel.
All right, here we go. Let's get the action going with the wheel.
Oh, my God.
All right, you are going to land on, okay, $150. Wonderful.
Fuck, cheap prick.
Yeah, that's what your mom told me when she paid me to suck it. So anyway,
how dare you? She has to make a living, you know.
So $150, give me a letter that might be up there.
All right, let's try R.
All right, yes, so there's going to happen to be two R's up there on the board. So
100.
What would you like to do now? You got the two R's up there.
Well, it's not cheap anymore. It's $100 now.
All right, so got the money, $300, right? Adding on a little bit of cash. So what would you like to do?
Right, here we go. I will buy a vowel, please.
All right, what vowel would you like?
May I have an E?
Yes, you're going to have to pick them. Not one, not two, but three as those beautiful blue lights come up. So you got the three E's up there. Go ahead. Ding, ding, ding. All right. What would you like to do? You got over $50, so obviously...
$50.
You either spin or solve the puzzle.
All right. I will spin the wheel.
All right. Now, remember, folks, it is a magazine title, so thank God for this program. It actually shows visually.
With the 50 bucks, you might get lucky and buy a hooker and give her some half and half.
Okay. You landed on the Mulligan card. 500 picked it up. So please call a letter first, then I'll pick. Then I'll put it on your podium, but let Romy explain what it is after you call your letter.
Yes.
Okay. I'll take an N.
Yes, you're going to happily pick up one up there. So go ahead, Tubbs, explain us what the
Mulligan is. Yes, now the Mulligan, it's like a blend between other wedges. Now, in golf, a Mulligan is where when you hit a ball and you want to give it a reshot, means that the shot that you did will not count and you get to try again. Same thing with here. If you land on a price amount that does not suit your appetite, you can spin again. However, this does not work against lose a turn or bankrupt due to the balance, since there's already other wedges that do that. So, and you can use it to your advantage, but that doesn't mean that it's a guarantee. So take that in mind.
So far it actually hasn't been used as of yet. But anyways, Connor, it's your choice if you want to spin or buy a vowel for...
I used it during my run, Gary. Oh, remember?
That's right. Johnny did use those.
He did use it, and it actually helped him.
Thank you for reminding me. Thank you for reminding me. I really do appreciate that. But anyways, go ahead, Connor. Let me know what your decision is.
I think I might solve.
Okay. What's the solution?
Okay. The New Yorker.
That is it.
Yep.
Wow. Hey, no.
What's the puzzle name?
The New Yorker.
New Yorker.
New Yorker. New Yorker.
All right, but anyways, go ahead, Tobes, explain us.
With the minimal of the 1,000, since if you solve a puzzle, you get the 1,000 added to his total with 39,230. Rod Dane's got 2 grand from the toss up. Kyle's got 10,530. Let's get to the mystery.
Alright, now, as for this, you all know how the mystery works, so Corey, please reveal us the next puzzle, please, and thank you.
Alrighty, let me go ahead and write this down right quick here so I can keep track.
Okay.
So... Now, Gary is going to wait till season 6 because I had an idea for the mystery round, and Gary loved it, but I have to plead the 5th and not say a word, so...
Alright, here comes the next puzzle. Just like your rape case.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Yep. All right. So Gary, he raped me, and you know what? It sucked.
Yeah.
I mean the sex.
No pun intended. But anyways, category for this is gonna be a book title, and it's a mystery.
Yep.
For granted, it's the top dollar amount. Ron Dane, since you started off with the first, you'll be starting off with this. So you ready to go?
Yes.
Alright, let me spin the wheel.
I'm surprised you didn't put something for wrestler yet.
Well, you never know. Alright,
I've done wrestling in the past many times.
750.
Good number.
Okay. N.
Oh, you're gonna happily get an N up there. There's two of them.
Oh, so 1500, good start.
Mm-hmm. Wow, this
ding, ding.
This program's amazing. But anyways, go ahead, Ron Dane. Got the twins up there.
I'll buy a vowel immediately.
What vowel would you like? An E?
An E.
Let's get up 2 E's up there.
1250.
Alright, good, good, good. But anyways, go ahead, Ron Dane. Doing well so far?
Spin, please.
Alright, we can do that for you. Oh, excuse me.
There you go again, Gary. Burping and fucking farting like you're always doing.
Ron Dane, there's...
go ahead.
Ron Dane, there's that trip to Japan. 500, pick that up.
Okay, Japan, a nice. T, please.
You're gonna pick up 2 T's up there.
Ding, ding.
And he's got that drip, so...
How much was it?
500 each, 1,000 total, 2250.
So you got that trip to Japan, solve the puzzle, it's all yours.
Alright, so I'll spin again.
Okay, let's go ahead and spin it again.
Welcome.
Thank you. Alright, you are going to land on a bankrupt.
Oh,
so, bye-bye trip to Japan, and Kyle, it's your turn.
My turn, Spin!
Alright, here we go.
Yeah, I'll get you to get those Asian ladies.
Okay, 200.
Yeah, H.
Alright, you're gonna happily pick up an H up there again? There's two of them.
Yeah.
Alright, so 400.
Number 2 has been pretty popular in this puzzle. But anyways, go ahead, you got 400 bucks. What would you like to do?
I would like to buy a vowel.
Alright, what vowel would you like?
An ooh.
Yes, there is. This time there's one of them.
So ooh. 150.
Whoa.
So go ahead, what would you like to do now?
What letter was that?
An O. Oh.
Alright, what would you like to do now?
I will spin.
Okay, we can do that. Alright, you are going to land on... Oh, there's that good vibrations wedge.
Okay, that wedge usually pays off excellent, so...
Give me a D.
There is one. So
five. Oh wow, excellent. 650.
Why would you want D, though? 500, pick that up, so go ahead.
I'm gonna buy an A.
There are two of them.
400.
Oh wow.
Alright, what would you like to do?
I'll spin.
Okay, we can do that. Three.
I'm just looking at that photo of the wrestling and memes.
$300.
F as in fuck!
There is one F and vowels are remaining in this whole puzzle.
Okay, 700.
Alright, I'm gonna solve it.
Alright, what's the solution?
The fountainhead.
That is it.
So your 10,530, excuse me, add to 700 would be 11,230. What is on this good vibration? It pays off well, so
well,
let's see what's
Kyle,
gonna happen.
I hope you got yourself some good luggage. As for that, I hope you love, I know you like traveling, if I'm not mistaken, you like traveling.
I do.
Well, you're gonna get yourself a mega fortune prize of an all around the world trip to China, Italy, Germany, Japan, Taiwan, Australia, France, Switzerland, Ireland, Iceland, and England.
What is this, the amazing race?
Literally, hey man, if it's all around the world trip, I mean literally, it's all around the world trip. This prize package is worth $26,000.
Holy shit. Oh, that thing usually pays off well, and here's the thing. He is behind by exactly, 37,230. So like I said, it's anybody's game.
That is big prizes. So
it's only down by 2 grand. Holy mama.
2 grand. That's it. Exactly, yeah. 2 grand.
I had a feeling this game was going to be exciting. So anyways, go ahead, folks. It's now time for that one round where it's a speed up.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you all right now, before we do that, it's time to get out your dial pads because it's time to...
Get out your dial!
No. So anyways...
hold on. I just got to bring the screen out so I can see everybody. Here we go. I can see everybody.
Okay. For $3,000, here's your final question of the game. What NFL team won the most Super Bowls in the 1980s?
Who is that? Is Kyle.
Yep, Kyle. The Steelers?
That is incorrect. It's not
that
the
is
Steelers.
Correct.
Who was that?
That was Rod Dane, I believe.
Was it Rod
Dane? Yeah, it's Rod Dane.
Okay.
Is it the Green Bay Packers?
That is incorrect. Carl, you're the only one.
I didn't want hazard a guess, and he said no.
He has no guess? Wow.
No, I don't know. Sorry.
I might have a guess.
Go ahead.
Denver Broncos?
No, it is.
I'll say it.
The 49ers.
Oh, the Niners!
There you go.
Yes.
My home team, the 49ers.
Fuck!
They
won Super Bowl 16, they won 19, and 23 all in the 1980s.
If you said Steelers in the 70s, you probably would be right, that or the Raiders. But yes, that is correct, the 49ers.
Corey, while you're getting yourself set up for the puzzle,
it's already ready, so
I'm just gonna turn on my camera just for a brief moment.
Where's my fucking little bat?
Alright, so anyways.
please get the bat, Romy.
Whatever.
I got the bat. I got two. One for his ass, and the other one for his ass.
Alright, here comes the next puzzle, guys.
Now watch it. Yeah, there he goes again. Yeah, go ahead, watch it. Yeah, spin that fucking wheel. Yeah, let the rubber ducky hold you.
How about I puke on the wheel, Gary? Hey, Kyle, do me a favor, puke on the wheel.
You player, if you don't stop that spin, I'm gonna spin my 45. Bitch. Alright.
Okay,
what
did it land on? 400, spin that motherfucker.
Actually, 1400? Okay.
$1,400 a piece, so anyways. Here's the final category of the game. Category is store and movie title.
Yes.
Anyway, since Connor is obviously in the lead, he'll be starting off, so it's going to be $1,400 a piece. So please go ahead, give me a letter that might be up there.
All right, here we go. S, please.
Please repeat an S.
S as in salad.
Okay, there's one S. Instead of 10 seconds, I changed it for the final time of 5 seconds now, because I want to keep the game moving. So, 5 All seconds right. starting now. 5.
1,500 for you, Connor. If you don't know, just say pass.
All right, next.
Okay.
All right, Rondane.
T.
Yes, there happens to be quite a few T's up there, because there's two of them.
Oh, shit. Oh, 2,800.
All right, 5 seconds. 5.
Pass. 4.
Okay, go ahead, Kyle.
R.
There happens to be one R in the puzzle, so...
Next!
Okay, that was quick. Go ahead.
Next.
Alright, hold on a sec, Gary. Hold on a sec.
One at a time. Everybody,
knock at the door. Hold on.
Calm your pancake tits.
Knock at the door! Oh my god!
After seeing that... pancake tits anyway.
With your massive dinner plate areolas.
What happened to you?
He went, he had a knock on his door.
Oh.
You mean he had to go lock his door?
Yeah.
All
bitches.
Alright, well anyways, for the time being, while Corey is taking care of a little something, let's see how Penelope and the ducky are holding up.
Oh, I don't think they're gonna do so well.
Oh, no.
Hey, rubber ducky, better stay away from my holes, or I'll slash your bitch ass. I can do whatever I want. I made Satan my bitch, I have no problem making yours.
Oh my god.
Man, you bitch ass. I had a cap up. Pop a cap in your ass, player.
Wow.
Oh god.
I'm gonna stick my hand up your ass and make you my own ventriloquist puppet.
Damn.
Come on, ice this deadbeat bitch ass.
Well, anyway,
sorry about that. One letter.
All right, whose turn is it? Oh, Connor's left off.
Is it my turn?
Yeah, it's your turn.
Yes. All right.
Let's try an N.
Yeah, you're gonna have me pick up two of those up there. So, 5
Ready?
Seconds right now.
4,200.
I'm gonna pass.
Okay, go ahead, Rondane.
L, please.
Oh, you're gonna get 1, 2, 3 of those up there. So, Ooh. Good letter. All right, 5 seconds.
7,000 even.
Alright, go ahead, Kyle.
C.
You're gonna get 1, 2, 3 C's up there.
Charlie Chaplin and City Lights.
There you go.
Oh, my.
Holy shit, I did it.
So, he got how many letters off that last one?
He got
three.
So, 5,600. Adding to the 1,400 that you got from the previous letter, 5,600, adding to the 37,000 and 230, gives him the overall lead of 42,830. You are our new champion. Connor, I know, man.
You almost had
That was intense, but I want to congratulate Kyle and the rest of the TOC, so congratulations.
All righty, so he's got... 42,830, Rondane. Thank you so much for playing, being a good trooper.
Yes. Good job, Rondane.
And Rondane, we will see you in the tournament.
Okay. Yes, yes. 52,000. That you won from the toss-up gives him an overall total of $123,070. We'll see you in the TOC. Mr. Kyle, best of luck to you in the bonus round. You have 42,830. Let's see if he can get that 100 grand.
All yeah, right. That'd be awesome.
Yeah,
but
like, if he gets 100,000,
that
ends
the
season.
Alright, I'm shaking for a piece of paper right now, an envelope.
You're shaking your dick!
Alright. Alright, I got one envelope.
His dick, aka his imaginary friend.
Hey, don't act like me, damn it, that's me.
Alright, but anyways, folks, let's get serious for a moment.
Yes, go ahead.
Category is living things. So, Corey, please reveal us the RSTLM. N-E.
I will give you the letters in the comment section, Gary, once he gives them out.
Okay. Alright, there's your R-S-T-L-E. So, Kyle, give us three more consonants and one vowel.
I'd like a B as in bitch.
Alright, that's one.
I'd like an H as in whore.
Alright, that's one. Alright, two.
I'll take a W as a whore.
Alright, and a vowel.
An I as in I'm going to fuck that gold-digging whore.
Alright, so you got...
I like this player. He speaks my language.
Alright, B-H-W-I is the letters that he called, so audience...
There you go.
Audience, please remain silent. Now, once the letters are revealed, Kyle, you got 10 seconds on the board. Talk it out, starting now.
White bunny rabbit!
That is it!
And that is it. The sound of that, he sounds like he's been playing the Manhunt game.
No, I'm... What's his name? Lenny from Mice and Men.
Hey! Oh, yeah. Wait, no. But George says I get to attend the rabbits!
Yeah, I get to attend the...
Oh, that was horrible.
All right. Yeah. Well, when I randomly shook that bag, it gave me a good envelope or paper, whatever it is.
And?
Let's just say the season's over.
Hey!
$100,000 motherfucking dollars!
Oh my god!
Okay, you want to talk about a turn of events? Kyle just came around and turned the tables upside
down. Holy shit!
Kyle!
Let's turn the tables upside down, inside out, like I do to Gary's blood.
How the hell did this happen?
Hey!
You are now the ninth and final competitor in the Tournament of Champions.
How the hell did that happen?
Anyways, I shook the bag up randomly.
Let me tell you something. Kyle just swept this game like Gary sweeps the floors at a peep show.
Holy shit.
Anyways, folks, the season's over. Well, 40 episodes. We had a hell of a season as it was for five. We had a lot of ups and downs as it is. And, that's all I gotta say for the season, so folks, stay tuned for the Tournament of Champions on what's gonna go down as it is. Then as soon as the Tournament of Champions is over, we will get stuff prepared for Season 6. So anyways, folks, that's gonna have to wrap up Season 4, 5 as it is.
Yes, 666, my favorite number.
Folks, I'm gonna tell you right now for a major announcement for Season 6, you'll be expecting a lot more not only shenanigans and shit to come, but a lot more originality and creativity for this season. A lot more is going to come. More new things.
Hence the word creativity.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So anyways, folks, that's going to have to wrap it. So please subscribe for more shit to come. And ciao for now.